Good afternoon. My name is Dante Villegas.
And my name is Alexis Vargas.
And this is our IB English FOA on our lyrical analysis of Keep Your Head Up by Tupac Shakur.
Background about women. So women were not viewed important in society. They had no rights on voting, getting education, speaking about their own ideas. They were taught to only become a housewife and mother only. Having to stay at home, cleaning and taking care of the children. They were also mistreated and seen as property. Some of the punishments they faced is having silence masks where they forcefully silenced them. They also had auctions for them when the man did not want them anymore, and they actually sold them to other people. In life at that time, women depend on being married because they had no equal rights as men.
With that being said, next is some context behind the actual song. So this song was written and released in 1993, which compared to older times in the past, it's a point in time when the harsh ideals and traditions aren't held onto so tightly by society. And people were starting to let go of these archaic beliefs of how men and women should fit into society. It was written in Baltimore, Maryland, which is in the U.S., just for reference. Now, the target audience of this song, we believe, was intended to be both men and women by Tupac, since in the song, there's a message and moral to be taken by both of them, and there's parts that apply to both, which we get into depth in the following slides.
So in the first group of lyrics, the start of the song, it creates a picture of a woman struggling to raise a child, while she is being degraded by men. Yet it speaks out to women that they should ignore their negative comments, and that women should be encouraged to find a man that will support and love her. I give my mother to my sister's own welfare. If don't nobody else care. And I know they like to beat you down a lot. When you come around the block, brothers clown a lot. But please don't cry, dry your eyes, never let up. Forgive, but don't forget, girl, keep your head. And when he tells you you ain't nothing, don't believe him. And if you can't learn to love, you should leave him. Cause sister, you don't need.
So, on to the second group of lyrics. In this section, Tupac utilizes a lot of repetition throughout to really emphasize the importance of what women have contributed and how men in turn have really paid them back, which is clearly in a terrible way and isn't really something warranted for everything that women do and what they mean to not just society, but the world. Here's the actual part of the song that says this. Unhass that when brothers make mates and leave a young mother to be a cat. And since we all came from a woman, got our name from a woman, and I came from a woman. I wonder why we take from our women, why we rape our women, do we hate our women? I think it's time to kill for our women, time to heal our women. Alright, and so towards the end, this is where Tupac really kind of, he starts talking about on how men should be more aware of this and need to start reciprocating all the work and contributions women make rather than hurting women and putting them down.
On the third group of lyrics, the way men are treating women in the 1990s, they were heavily negative and will continue unless there is a change. So men should not treat or control what women should do. They have no right on doing so. Forcing women to give them what they want, or as a child, they are not properties anymore. They should be treated respectfully. And if we don't, we'll have a race of babies that will hate the ladies that make the babies. And since a man can't make one, he has no right to tell a woman when and where to create one. So will the real men get up? I know you're fed up, ladies.
Alright, so relating to the genre. So in rap music, it's pretty typical of writers to include lyrics that are degrading women heavily, and they represent them in negative connotations through the way they describe them in their language and choice of words. In addition to that, they make a lot of blanket statements, really. So this meaning that like they will say things that apply to that they will apply to most women, even though it doesn't really apply, at least when they specify. And when they do, they also objectify women a lot. And some good examples of this are in these pictures where they degrade women in their overall image. And a lot of this comes from the culture surrounding rap, and it's the most average depiction of women in most rap music, unfortunately.
On the other hand, Tupac's song has an extremely different perspective on how men should view women. He respects them. He respects the role and the nature of a woman lifting their spirits to be themselves and be independent. Also, enforcing men to start realizing how important women are and they need to be treated better. Trying to find equality on both males and females needing to support one another.
So, this same message of unity and affirmative action for men that Tupac includes in the song are also found in other works as well. A prime example of this being in the Gillette "The Best Men Can Be" advertisement.
Bullying. The Me Too movement against sexual harassment.
Toxic masculinity.
Is this the best a man can get? Is it? We can't hide from it. It's been going on far too long. We can't laugh it off.
Who's the daddy? What I actually think she's trying to say.
Making the same old excuses.
Boys will be boys.
Boys will be boys.
Boys will be boys.
But something finally changed.
Allegations regarding sexual assault and sexual harassment.
And there will be no going back. Because we believe in the best in men.
Men need to hold other men accountable.
Smile, sweetie.
Come on.
To say the right thing. To act the right way.
Bro, not cool, not cool.
Some already are. In ways big.
Yo, men, we're acting like
shit. And small.
I am strong.
But some is not enough.
Is that how we treat each other, okay?
Okay.
Because the boys watching today will be the men of tomorrow.
Thank you. So, this ad portrays messages of men essentially changing their ways in order to help other men around them be the best they can be. So, pretty much to help them be better and treat others better, which says that it isn't enough to just not be one of the bad ones, but to push other men to also reform and be a little more conscious of how they treat others and how they see the world. Rejecting the traditional toxic masculinity and the misogynistic tendencies, which is the same thing that Tupac was trying to say nearly 30 years ago. So what this leads us to believe is that this is just a message that is still relevant even today, and it's something that both men and women can still take away from after all this time, as history has shown us.
A bibliography. We have the links for the Silencing Mask and Wife Auction. This is talking about the history in the past where they were being punished. We have the link to the Tupac Eat Your Head Up lyrics and also the video for the Gillette, and including the music video that we used.
And this concludes our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you.